in England from Monday were introducing the rule of six. You must not meet socially in groups of more than six, and if you do, you will be breaking the law. This will apply in any setting, indoors or outdoors, at home or in the pub. The ban will set out in law and it will be enforced by the police. And anyone breaking the rules risks being dispersed, fined, and possibly arrested. This single measure replaces both the existing ban on gatherings of more than 30 and the current guidance on allowing two households to meet indoors. Now you only need to remember the rule of six. There will be some limited exemptions. For example, if a single household or support bubble is larger than six, then obviously they can still gather. COVID-secure venues like places of worship, gyms, restaurants, hospitality venues can still hold more than six in total. Within those venues, however, there must not be individual groups larger than six, and groups must not mix socially or form larger groups. Education and work settings are unaffected. COVID-secure weddings and funerals can go ahead up to a limit of 30 people, and organised sport will still be able to proceed. As we've found on previous occasions, this rule of six will, of course, throw up difficult cases. For example, two whole households will no longer be able to meet if they would together exceed the limit of six people. And I'm sorry about that, and I wish that we did not have to take this step. But as your Prime Minister, I must do what is necessary to stop the spread. First of all, on the whether we're going to get things back to normal at all by Christmas, I'm still hopeful, as I've said before, that in many ways we could be able to get some aspects of our lives back to normal by Christmas. And I talked just now about how you could do that through that moonshot of daily testing. Everybody gets a pregnancy-style test, a rapid turnaround test in the morning. 15 minutes later, you know whether you're infectious or not. You may not know whether you're infected or not, but you know whether you're infectious or not. And that gives you a kind of passport, a laissez-passer, a freedom to mingle with everybody else who is similarly not infectious in a way that is currently impossible. And you might be able to do that in the theatres, in cinemas, at sporting venues, and so on, in places of work. That's the opportunity. And we're aiming for that, Robert. We're driving for that. As I've said just now, we cannot be 100% sure that we can deliver that in its entirety. But what I do think we can do, if we can follow the, whatever happens, if we can follow the guidance strictly, if we follow the rule of six, then what we can certainly do is get on with controlling this virus. I think we've got a very good chance of controlling the current upturn in the numbers of infections, and continue with the most important thing, which is the openings up of the economy that we've seen since June the 1st, since the July the 4th openings. Continue with school pupils, with students being back at their places of education, which is so vital for their future. Continue with the movement forward, the forward movement of our economy. So that's what this measure is all about. It's a stitch in time to save nine, if you like. That's the purpose, and that's why it's important that everybody is so vigilant with the rule of six.